certainly think, and nothing better than the last presentation, that what you have been doing here during the last years, and certainly this year, which was the only one I could appreciate, we are celebrating opportunities, and we thank you for that. It's very impressive. It's very clear that to me, that didn't know anything about trends, but I also was born in the environment of trends, so my grandfather was supervisor for train maintenance in Portugal, so whenever I visited him, I stayed in a train station more or less, so it was very nice. And what I learned here is for sure that the trains open a lot of articulations, so articulations between passions, as it was well demonstrated here today, between a lot of anger and eventually problems like strikes and all these issues. So a lot of human elements. But it was also clear that trains do also articulate a lot of science, a lot of scientific endeavors. So we have here today, of course, architects, engineers, well, I would say poets. But of course, nothing will make sense without a sense of the history. And of course, I left history to the end. I could fully appreciate the importance of ITER's history for us to understand better this articulation between the different elements, the different disciplines, and how far we can go on all of this. But of course, there is also a very special articulation which created the opportunity for this project. And this is a wonderful articulation between a company, EDP, between the university, and of course, with the passion of Eduardo Beira, which of course, I would, and I think you will always accompany me in a huge clapping, so. I certainly knew Eduardo was a passionate person, but I could not believe before having been here and see his joy with you, his friends, his community that he has recently developed, and also with that machine down there. And I want to go there with you, if possible. That would be very interesting. But of course, when saying all of this and remembering my keyword, which is opportunity, I strongly believe that opportunity is created by knowledge. And what you are doing here as well is providing the knowledge that we need in order to achieve a better opportunity. And it was so eloquently demonstrated by you, I loved, of course, your presentation. The opportunity today is not national, it's not regional, it needs to be international. And that's where I really thank Anne McCann and the colleagues that came from all over the world with their different experiences and brought different sciences together. And this introduces me to the MIT Portugal program. The MIT Portugal program is no more than bringing people together to Portugal, with Portugal, to bring in the academic community, to bring the companies, and to bring the local people, to bring the Portuguese, and to bring them upwards, to create opportunities for us, and to have a better impact in the world, in which we certainly do have a place. And we want to have a place in the world, but this place needs to be shared with others. I hope that I can now use your word, so let's develop the technology landscapes that we need for the future. And again, Eduardo, thank you very much for putting the program, the MIT Portugal program, forward, and thank you all for what you have done. Thank you so much.